Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Antelope Valley Fair for the 2016 Motorsports Events. We here at Low Budget TV, I'm Jeffrey Best with Tommy Mason, are super excited. Tommy, coverage this year going bigger and badder than ever.
For the first time, we'll be covering three motorsports events, actually all three motorsports events here at the Antelope Valley Fair. Very happy to do so, very happy that the fair personnel let us, hey, there's a tease of what we're going to be doing tomorrow night, so check that video out here on YouTube, Obsession and Obsessed with other monster trucks. That'll be tomorrow. This is a Thursday. Tomorrow, Friday night, will be monster trucks, and then Sunday, another video worth checking out, the Antelope Valley Fair Demolition Derby.
Always a big one, Tommy.
Yeah. So,
but you know what? I know that a Demolition Derby is all about crunching up cars, but I feel like sometimes the figure eight race manages to have the most carnage of the weekend.
It's titled a race, but sometimes it doesn't end up that way. It's definitely about attrition and survival. Here comes your first heat race of the Antelope Valley Fair figure eight night. The number 50 starts on the pole. That is number 50 of Jeremy Edwards. To be starting on his outside will be the number 44. That is Johnny Troche. Inside row number two is what could be a redemption race for him, but also could be maybe an example of what could have been last year. The number four, that is piloted by Cole Hines, and then to his outside scheduled would be the 79. That is piloted by Mike Hopkins. The 49, we mispronounced his name last year, but this year it is going to be Ken Lucazonas in the number 49. And rounding out the field, we got the 31 of Travis Shepard.
Well, Tommy, so we get it. This is the appetizer portion of the night. We have six cars ready to go here in this figure eight race. We have multiple track cameras. But our favorite, the onboard camera, is going to be taking us through the action here tonight.
Got the number 44 piloting our one of many in-car cam or roof cameras, I should say. The number 44, Johnny Troche. And then behind,
here we go.
We got the four of Hines carrying a camera. We go green, heat number one.
Tommy, they just slicked up this track. The water truck just went at it. Dumped a couple gallons.
And how about this battle for the second spot, getting some contact. Jeremy Edwards, winner of the last year event, is out in the lead at the moment. Second place is Hines in the number four. And we got some cars bouncing around. We got an ex-wife in the trunk of the number 49 machine.
I'm sorry, we have a what?
An ex-wife, if you zoom in. I believe there's also a speaker in the back. You see the speaker held on by some Home Depot ratchet straps. He's got a CD player duct taped to the dashboard.
Oh, where are we going?
And you see 31 and the 44 Troche.
Oh, boy.
Getting stuck on the teardrop over on the left side of the track.
And it's one of the things, Tommy, that we'll definitely pay attention to by the time we get to the main event. We see cars each year get stuck up on that berm, and it knocks them out of the competition.
Jeffrey Chino has the moat. Antelope Valley Fair has the curb in the intersection. Lucazonas sneaks by with a couple of slides on in. Jeremy Edwards has led this one from the start. Hines has been trying to close in on the 50. But you see about a half lap ahead, everybody behind battling for third. Lucazonas in the 49 holding on to third, 31.
What a pretty 49 car.
Yeah, that car we've seen we've seen it go the entire weekend last year.
White
running
flag
the figure eights.
Is out for the 50 machine of Jeremy Edwards. And Tommy, once we conclude this race, we'll talk a little bit about the controversy from last year.
Yep, here we go.
And your leader!
Trying to hold on. Here comes Hines. He's trying to use advantage of it, not able to get the job done. Jeremy Edwards gets the job done here. And Hines going to spin it out a half track ahead of third, so no worries there. But Jeremy Edwards winning the first heat of the night. We got another heat race coming up next.
So they are saying that the top four move on to the main event, Tommy. But are you like me? Are you shaking your head like I am going, uh-huh? We hear that every year.
Yes, we do.
Folks,
it's a great tease for the fans.
It's a tease and it gives some incentive, but our records show that typically we see all the cars return. Interesting for Johnny Trosh, Tommy, a driver that does quite a bit of competing out here in the Antelope Valley. Just kind of keeping an eye on how bad his car is or how good his car is. But Tommy right now is going to step away and take care of some camera management as we get ready for the second heat here at the Antelope Valley Fair. Heat race number two on track and ready to go as seven cars have made it to this point. 13 cars in total here tonight. As we get ready to go, the 55 of Jerome Utiger is going to be starting on the pole in this one. And then, Tommy, you go from a car that you could be convinced could be a dirt track racing car to a car that I'm pretty sure is a big old derby car.
Yeah, definitely. How about another Utiger? That is Derek Utiger in the number five. Then we got the number seven, followed by Justin DeJanes, the 88 of Tim Doherty, the 5150 of Kenny Boysvert, the 14 that is driven by Peyton Zamerslaw, and the 41 of Corey Carter.
All right. As we get ready to go for this one, Tommy, it's time to go racing again.
It sure is. Heat race number two for the Antelope Valley Fair figure eights. Looks like we're going to give them one more to go green.
Now, we brought this up in the previous race, Tommy, about last year, about a little bit of controversy that took place last year. Maybe fill everyone in.
So what happened last year, Trevor? We announced, and you can even go back and watch the end of this video.
It's a good one.
It's a good one. It was a fantastic race, except for there's controversy at the end. The drivers argued with us. We argued against the officials by their scoring because the number four of Cole Hines, we thought, took the win last year. He was just in his last heat race. But Jeremy Edwards was awarded the win.
Also in the last heat race.
Exactly. And they were actually one and two in the heat race. Here we go for the green. What ended up happening was, I believe, a miscalculation on laps. And that actually helped Jeremy when he was technically about two laps down. Look at this pack going through.
Boy.
Zamerslaw on that inside goes from about fifth to the lead in one straightaway. Around goes Jerome Utiger in the 55.
Is now a good time to remind everybody that we also destroyed one of our cameras last year?
Yeah, we can mention that.
Oh, look at them slide. This is a slick track tonight.
Beating and banging throughout this one. Yeah, and they just watered the track again between heats. So making it nice and greasy for us here.
Lap traffic for your leader.
So actually, we got a battle for the second spot. Utiger holding on to the second spot in front of DeJanes. Utiger in the five.
Someone's in reverse, and your leader gets clipped.
By Boysvert. So the 14 of Utiger.
We're having...
I'm sorry, the 14... I apologize. That is Zamerslaw getting tagged in the intersection. We got Corey Carter going in reverse. He nudges.
It's not a good lap for the 14 car.
No, definitely not.
I think the 41 only has reverse, Tommy.
Yeah, that car's been having transmission issues throughout the day. Yeah, the last minute car. Here comes DeJanes nearly colliding. Over here in the corner, the 14 of Zamerslaw almost doing, but he gets off. Easy on that one, almost doing exactly what his teammate had in the first heat.
Now for heat races, this has been exceptionally clean so far.
True.
If you're watching this going, how is this clean? Just wait until you see the main event.
Zamerslaw making it known by the 5150, or to the 5150, that he did not appreciate that intersection tag. He runs into the back of Boysvert. And Jeffrey, I was talking to Boysvert earlier in the day in the pits while I was putting a camera on his car, and he goes, "I'm out here, I'm hunting." I'm like, "Oh, are you hunting for the win? Are you hunting for the win there, Kenny?" And he goes, "No, I'm just trying to hit everybody who's in my way." And I think he's just done that.
You know, it's worth pointing out that just a week ago, Tommy, you and I were both in a demolition derby with Boysvert.
Yes, we were. Here we go, through the last corner, the number seven, Justin DeJanes going to take
the heat. He tried to hit our camera.
The heat race number two victory, DeJanes in the seven. And yeah, pile up over in the corner. That's actually second and third that just piled up and lost a ton of spots.
That was a rough heat race for the 14.
Yeah. He's not happy, you can guarantee yourself that.
I can't help but notice there's a GoPro on the roof of that car, Thomas.
Yes, there is.
Oh, we're still wrecking, by the way.
Hey, we got to finish the damn race. Who's going to get it across the line? And it's going to be... I don't know. That was a photo finish. That was legitimately a photo finish.
So, going back to what we discussed just before this race, the controversy, Tommy. One funny thing that you and I both noticed this year is that, you know, as we discussed, sometimes it helps to have video review or whatnot.
Yeah.
I'm going to look just slightly to the right. And what's next to us this year?
Well, actually, we are the ones that normally film in that location. We got bumped over by about 30 feet of temporary table. Race control is located next to us. So I think maybe...
We're probably giving ourselves way too much credit.
Yeah, we could be the ones to blame, or it could be...
They're making sure that we don't talk crap.
Yeah, Jeffrey, race control right next to us.
They're going to black flag us.
Maybe getting a better view. I don't know. We'll find out.
All right. Well, we'll be back, I believe, for the main event coming up next.
Oh, boy. So, Jeffrey, you know how we were kind of wondering or playing it off as they're never going to do a B-Main because we're not transferring cars. This is a B-Main.
It's a B-Main.
It's a legitimate B-Main. We got four cars, two cars transferring in this B-Main. Starting up front, the number 79, that is driver Mike Hopkins. Then we got the 55 of Jerome Utiger, the 14, who had a horrible second heat race, Peyton Zamerslaw, and another driver who got stuck in his first heat race, the number 44 of Johnny Troche. Two cars transfer, four cars in this B-Main event. And it looks like we're getting ready to bump into each other and,
yeah,
and double file them.
Got a couple on boards on this one.
We got half the field. And ironically, they're teammates. The back row has some onboard cameras.
So, Tommy, it looks like, from what you can assess, you've walked the track a bit.
Yes.
I imagine it's a lot chunkier there than it looks from up here.
It sure is, Jeffrey. Here we go. Green flag flying. Who's going to make it into the main event here at the Antelope Valley Fair annual figure eight night? And trouble for the 79, unable to get under power out of the second.
Troche is also under pace in the 44.
So two cars, this could be what's going to change out our B-Main. Mike Hopkins, who is literally pulling it off into the pit area. Troche, able to get his car fired up. So with this, we got a battle for the lead in this B-Main event and some contact.
Where are you going?
Jerome Utiger going to second spot now as Zamerslaw moves into the lead. Your top two, in theory, have no pressure as Troche again stalls in the intersection.
Yeah, we've seen that 44 car have issues all night long.
Jeffrey, we've seen that 44 car for many years out here.
Yeah.
I wonder, oh, there it goes again. I wonder if that car is tired or Johnny's tired of driving it. Oh, Zamerslaw having all sorts of issues. White flag lap. All he's got to do is bring it home these next two corners.
You can tell him that, but I don't think he's going to drive any different.
Not at all. Here we go. So Peyton Zamerslaw on the 14 takes a B main event win and moves into the show. As Utiger, Jerome Utiger, rounds out your top two. So those two cars are guaranteed into the show. I just wonder if they're the contingency plan for the, maybe it's a promoter's provisional.
Well, Tommy, next
two.
Up is going to be the main event, but I want to talk a little bit more about this track, talking about its chunkiness. How are the track conditions here tonight?
Jeffrey, this track, so this track, you know, we go to dirt tracks, they got clay. This track is literally in the arena area of this Antelope Valley Fair. What am I doing? I'm playing with my microphone.
Yeah, you are.
Anyway, so this is literally a dirt carved course. They take a tractor, they take a blade, and they cut it a figure eight, and that's it. They water it down. It's just dirt. That's why you're seeing the chunkiness. That's why you're seeing the roost coming off of these cars. And, yeah, this track is nothing special, but that's what makes it special out here. It's very unique, and definitely the drivers and us fans get a kick out of it. It's main event time here at the Antelope Valley Fair, figure eight night, annually here on a Thursday towards the end of the fair in Lancaster, California. Jeffrey, we got the 20-lap figure eight main event coming up now, and defending champion of this event, the number 50 of Jeremy Edwards, starts on the pole after winning his heat race to his outside, the number 7. That is piloted by Justin D. James. Inside row number 2 has the number 49, driven by Ken Lucasonas, and to his outside, the 5150 of Kenny Boysvert. Row 3 has the number 31, driven by Travis Shepard, and to Travis's outside, the number 5 of Derek Udiger. Cole Hines in the number 4 starts inside row number 4 to his outside, the number 88. That is piloted by Timothy Doherty. And your last row of figure eight competitors has the number 14 of Peyton Zamerslaw and the number 55 of Jerome Udiger. Now we're looking over to the left side of the arena, the 44 of Johnny Trosh, who had issues in the B main and the heat race. Looks to be pulling off the track and into the pits.
See, the 79 parked as well.
Yeah, the 79 unable to complete his night of racing. So unfortunate for those two drivers, 79 of Mike Hopkins. All right, so it looks like the field bunched up, ready to go.
So we theorized, Tommy, that you know, even though we're having heats, we're having B mains, maybe we'll get everyone. But ironically enough, the cars that weren't able to make this race were the ones that ended up getting cut anyway.
Yeah, Jeffrey, definitely. So we had a full field of the full field entries, except for we lost two cars. All right, so it looks like the field getting possibly the two to go the last time by, which means the next time by will be one to go, if my math is correct. And here we go.
There's an ex-wife.
Yeah, zoom in on the back. We got a subwoofer speaker in the back.
I don't think that's going to last.
No, I think that's the point. And then buried in there, you see the head of the ex-wife sticking out of the trunk there on our side. And then it even says on the sign, my ex-wife. So Lucasonas making it known.
He has an ex-wife.
He's got an ex-wife. Had an ex-wife.
Had an ex-wife.
She is, well, I guess still technically if she's on the back seat, the rumble seat of that Lincoln or Ford.
Whatever it was.
All right, so quickly before this race, Jeffrey, Jeremy Edwards, he wants to go back-to-back wins. The 7, probably the newest car here of DeJanes, is sitting pretty in the outside front row. He wants it too. Kenny Boysvert said he's aiming for anybody in his way. The green flag flies, and Derek Udiger says if he can't do any good on the first few laps, he's going to go crazy, he says.
Did we? I think we lost the subwoofer.
Oh boy, battle over here in the first couple of corners. DeJanes takes the lead out of turn number 2. Lucasona is going to slide towards your flag, man.
Oh man. And Tommy, you know, talking about Edwards with the lights on top, you know, for him, because of the controversy of last year, he's out to prove himself.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, I deserve that win. I'm out here to show you guys again.
Jeremy Edwards, Jeffrey. Boysbert's going to hit the tractor tire, knock over the flagman's flags. I don't know if the flagman can actually get his flags anymore.
Udiger's
Udiger's already going backwards.
What's funny is he's battling for second backwards.
He's in second, battling in reverse. Look out, everybody coming. Boom, into Edwards. This is what Derek's known for.
Oh, yeah.
Going crazy.
Hines takes a shot. That was one of the cars that we were keeping an eye on. Oh, and delivers a shot.
Delivers one to Udiger.
So DeJanes is our leader in the 7 machine. Edwards spins it out over in the intersection.
So that's about a half lap behind Edwards is. Jerome Udiger spins it out in front of second spot.
And figuring.
Lucasonas. And a big hit.
Yep.
Udiger slams into the side of Zamerslaw as we go green. We're still green. The field trying to have to weave their way through. Zamerslaw gets a 14 fired up. I imagine Udiger is stuck there in the infield. Boysvert finally gets it going again.
And now Zamerslaw doesn't care about his car. Oh!
And more intersection, the 31 in the second spot. He gets collected with a 50 of Edwards.
DeJanes, Tommy, running away with this.
He is closing in on unlapping a few more cars in this big area in front of him. What does that mean for him, though? Try to tiptoe his way through because all the cars he's coming up on are all wrecking each other in front of him.
I don't know quite what's going on over that turn.
So if my order is what I believe is correct, it's the 7 of DeJanes, your leader going through the intersection. The second spot will be... DeJanes actually stuck on the outside of the figure eight course. This could be the battle for the lead. The 31, who was stuck for a little bit.
31 got shoved out, Tommy.
That's what I mean. The only other car that I would imagine in second spot is Lucasona's in the 49. So, yeah, it's all crazy right now. But we do know that DeJanes is in the lead by at least 3/4 of a track.
Taking a look at, you see Edwards over there. The 50 machine, very promising with the heat races.
And Boysford slamming it to the 88. More contact through the intersection. Like we'd mentioned, Jeffrey.
It's such an interesting combination in these races here at the Antelope Valley, Tom. You have kind of cars that easily could be contenders for the win, as in like race car cars. And then you have guys that bring out straight up derby cars like Utica.
Boysford, like we'd mentioned, Jeffrey, he said he's out here to just hammer whoever's in his way.
And I believe he's doing that. Edwards is really struggling on exit.
Yeah, maybe a flat tire. Looks like a right rear could be flat, or I could just be seeing things.
Boysford's just going to hits left and right now.
Yeah, Boysford's just going to plow through everything.
See Hines over there in the four machine carrying a left rear flat tire and hitting. Tommy, it's going to be a survival race.
It is, and I believe DeJanes, your leader right now, the number 7, has all but lapped the number 49. If not, he's done so probably a few times. So I think we have a difference by a lap on lead versus second spot.
DeJanes stopping.
I mean, what's it?
Probably smart.
Yeah. At this point, he's got the least damage on the 7.
And for him, it's just about finishing the race.
Yeah, man. All he's got to do is finish at this point.
Taking a look at the chains. Playing very safe. Which isn't easy to do out here. As you've seen, we're halfway. Here comes Boysburg in the 51-50.
Cole Hines in the number 4, who we thought was the winner last year. Having all sorts of trouble this year. Your red flag is out. Red flag is out. Not too sure as to why. The red flag is out.
My favorite are the guys that are literally driving right by the flag, man.
Yeah. And funny enough, Zamerslaw, I believe, just got stuck on the teardrop while driving right past the flag, man.
I imagine we're going to take a look and see how Utiger's doing.
Utiger made a big hit there in the intersection. I don't know if this is more of a recoup the order. Or if this is a removal of cars. Or maybe removal of drivers from their parked cars.
We know that we have less than 10 laps to go in this event. Couple drivers.
Yeah, so they're going to be moving cars. Jeffrey, from what I would guess, and maybe you can agree or disagree, but I'm to guess that your top three is going to be the 7 of DeJanes, an obvious leader.
Yep.
Second spot, the number 49 of Lucasona's. And third, I'm going to have to go with the number 88. From what
seem
I've
to be
seen,
the drivers that have had the least amount of issues.
Yeah, Tim Doherty in the 88, Jeffrey. So those are the top three that I believe. You tell me if I am right or wrong.
I know the 14 machine's been fast, but in trouble.
Exactly.
Like, for example, Boysvert, the 5150, we know that he was stuck for a few laps right at the beginning. Hines has had his issue with the
Hines has been stuck, and we saw him having his issues in the first corner.
And Edwards, although I don't see flat tires on the front end, that he cannot get that thing to... He can't steer it for anything.
The front end won't work, and the back end slides around.
You mentioned Zamerslaw being stuck. He's actually getting a favor right now with this red flag. So, favoritism in NASCAR.
Gotta love the Jeeps that are our official tow vehicles.
But Tommy Jerome Utiger in the 55 is another car that's really hung in there in this race. I imagine he's got to be up there in the top five.
I would imagine top five easily. In fact, I only think there might be only five cars left in this race.
So it'll be really easy to figure out who's in the top five.
Exactly.
Well, we're going to take a look here at the damage on the five machine of Derek Utiger, Tommy.
Is that GoPro still flashing? If it is, that means we had footage of it.
Did you charge him?
I did.
And I feel good. Did you?
I didn't stop him in between. I did.
Man, you're a good guy.
I, of course, formatted him minutes before the race start.
That's the only way to do it. That was a big shot. We see the 31 being towed off. This car, not with too much front end damage, but just one blow to the intersection too much. And he's about to take out the truck that's towing him.
Now, Jeffrey. This Antelope Valley Fair.
I think something happened to the tow job over here.
These drivers, these cars, only really get raced out here once a year. Local, I should say. And this is a big event for them. This is their once a year event, so they're out here to either win the show or put on a show.
Yeah.
And we see that a lot in these figure eight races. Come Sunday, if you're ever in the Antelope Valley, and you want to come check out a motorsports event at the fair, Thursday night is figure eight racing. Friday night, monster trucks. Mm-hmm. We'll have full video coverage of that here on our YouTube channel, so go ahead and take a look. And then Sunday is the finale of the fair as they finish it off with a destruction derby. So a lot of locals competing in the car action out here. And like we'd mentioned, Jeffrey, these drivers out here doing it once a year. This is their time to shine. And if they're not winning, they're going to do everything they can to put on the show.
Do you see a problem here?
Looks like there's a Jeep towing a car. Maybe that's how many Jeeps are needed to pull that big number five machine.
It's kind of a warm-up show for Utiger.
You see, Utiger's back wheels aren't turning, so it could be locked up. Rear end or the impact.
Maybe he doesn't want to leave the track. He had a good seat. Probably hold the brakes.
That's true.
But Tommy noticed our last year winner, Edwards, in the 50 machine, pulling it in. Drove it off the track.
Jeremy Edwards will be here Sunday as well. He'll be participating in the demolition derby just with a different car.
Dude, we're taking a look underneath the front end.
Paul Hines going to take his number four machine into the pit area to, I believe, change the left rear flap.
It's a good opportunity for it right now. We might see some of these cars, Tommy. Not unusual for us to see cars make it back onto the track during a red flag like this. So some of the cars, like the 31 machine, I see them going to work, trying to see if they can solve any issues with that car.
Cole Hines going to his pit area. We right now have four cars left running on the track. Cole Hines, they're working on that left rear, though. You can see him in the pit area all the way to our left.
Yeah, that car will be back on track.
It's too good running of a car.
Though, I think he needs to help change the tire because he's already out of the car.
Got to do what you got to do.
I like the the way they're keeping the radiator cool. They're just dousing it down now as if the car's on fire.
Got it. Yeah, and that car's been parked for a while there. It's probably all muddied up, too.
Well, this is a big twist here, though. The 49 machine, Tommy, you were speculating, could have been up in the top three.
Not anymore.
This car, we saw it smoking during the red flag.
Yeah, I
period.
Believe it lost a radiator hose. It steamed up and then continuously smoked. I saw it steam out, so I could tell the hose blew up on it.
And then we talked about Jerome Utiger potentially up in the top five.
Not the case anymore.
We're halfway, we're at 10. Taking a look over here to see if Hines is able to continue on track. He's still jacking up the left side. Go fast
enough that you don't overheat. I'm now guessing that DeJanes is your leader. Boisvert and the 88 are your top three, 88.
You don't think the 14 machine's up in second since they lined up in second?
Well, that's where I'm getting at, but he was stuck there for a while. he's had a lot of issues. So Timothy Doherty in the 88 in the back of this one. So that could be our running order as of right now.
It's like they're trying to finish up on the four of Hines. It would give us five cars to finish off this race. They're still trying to tow off Jerome Utiger in the 55. He's just clear of the track as we speak. See him over to the left in that yellow machine. So, Tommy?
Well, if I'm going to be, as we go green, if I'm going to be D-James, I'll do everything I can to finish this race as clean as possible. Because it's literally his race to lose right now.
Well, Boysford is just trying something new.
Yeah. Boysford looks like he has no... Caps our camera and keeps on going. Jerome Utiger back on the racetrack.
He didn't even get pulled off to his pits.
No. So, while we're down to three, we're back to four.
So Boysford is sitting over here in the turn.
Looks like Boysford could have lost a tie rod or something, because he went straight when he meant to turn left.
So DeJane's obviously looking really good. I thought that 14 car was taking our camera with him.
Oh, he did come really close. Utiger having to back it up.
Hines is going to make it back on track in the 14 machine, guaranteeing him. Well, I was going to say guaranteeing him a top five, but then I look over and I see Boysford's back running. Tommy, I think you might be close on what the issue may be for Boysford.
That car, I mean, the way it went straight.
Just some. I mean, we've seen things breaking scary.
That was a close. Welcome back, Cole Hines.
Utiger, Jerome Utiger, not enjoying turns one and two. James here in the seven machine gets some pressure.
He's getting a lot of pressure from Zamerslaw.
And Zamerslaw wants to knock this seven car out, Tommy, because that can open up the door for victory.
Spin him out, put him in the teardrop, whatever it takes, but that's not going to help. Cole Hines and Zamerslaw making some contact in the intersection there. They keep it going. Boysford on the front straightaway. Take a look at the 5150, Jeffrey, and yeah, it doesn't look like the steering is wanting to cooperate.
But he was able to get it to this point, which means he's obviously able to steer.
Yeah.
Oh, and losing an axle and into the K-rail and up in the air. This belonged to the four machine. I don't think they tightened the lug nuts down, Tommy.
I would believe so.
That was the tire that they just exchanged.
I don't know what that thing is over there in the corner, but it's avoided the wheel twice. So Cole Hines not having the figure eight redemption race as he had planned. Jeremy, the smoke coming out of your leader.
See that?
DeJane's having some smoke coming out from under the hood of the number seven. Justin DeJane's has a few more laps to complete his big win. Like I said, it's literally his race to lose. He has more contact.
I'm telling you, that 14 machine. Now what's funny is that this is the... We're doing it again with the announcer.
Yeah.
The announcer's calling the 14 your leader.
Yeah,
the white flag's going out to the 14.
So maybe we're wrong again this year. Maybe we're the problem. But,
yeah, okay.
Zamerslaw getting the white flag after an attrition-filled race for him. He might be the underdog in this one. He's going to come out of turn number four and take the checkered flag in tonight's Antelope Valley figure eight race. DeJanes, who we thought had led this one from flag to flag, is actually the driver who's finishing second here, according to race results. And with that, Doherty, I believe, will finish third, and the 55 of Utiger finishing fourth. And somebody got pulled over on Interstate 14. To cap off the night of action. So we are confused again here on Low Budget TV here at the Antelope Valley Fair.
And it's not, I don't think it's just us, Tommy, because you see two cars pulling up to victory.
Yeah, I know. Either way, we're the big winners because we had cameras on those two cars. So
hey, we win. That 14 put on a show. But Tommy, like you said, much like last year, we sit here with asking the question of who won this race. I feel like maybe there's a rule we keep missing that when the red flag comes out,
it resets us
to go, everybody's on the lead lap. But even then, that 14 machine went through quite the wild ride. The 14 proved himself to be faster on this entire night.
Yeah.
And why?
I tell you what, he had a lot of survival to go through in this figure race. So, now, a well-deserved win.
Steve Jane's having a conversation.
Yeah, I believe he's talking to race controller, official, or whatever. But DeJane's finishing second, officially. And the 14 of Zamerslaw getting his big win here tonight in the figure eight race here at Antelope Valley Fair. What a fun night, Jeffrey. We had Democrats. We had a lot of figure eight racing.
Well, props to the 7 machine. DeJanes, whether or not he did win the race, he clearly, Tommy, set the precedence in this one.
Yes, he did. He also has the cleanest car out of everybody here tonight.
Even still now, that's what's impressive. He got dumped multiple times by the guy who we're calling our winner.
And there he is, Zamerslaw, Peyton Zamerslaw. Your winner here tonight in victory lane. Congratulations.
Well, another wild one. Another one that will certainly see plenty on social media about.
It's in the books. It's official, unofficially. And congratulations to our winners here tonight.
See how many people were driving this car. Pretty impressive.
A lot of team in that 14.
Hey, Peyton, you need to come down here front. We got 3 young ladies.
So they're taking care of the trophy situation here, Tommy. Another fun figure eight race. I mean, you know, as far as we sit, we're big on knowing the orders, knowing the results.
We don't care who wins or loses. You know, we have a fun time just enjoying the show.
That's what I was going to say. These fans, they came out here to see some close calls, maybe some intersection hits, some guys pushing it. We saw some good stuff tonight.
Yeah, and it's always fun here to document it. Here on Low Budget TV, we appreciate all of your support in Low Budget TV here at Antelope Valley, the staff here at the fairgrounds, and everybody involved. Of course, like I said, we still have plenty of content from this weekend of motorsports here at the Antelope Valley Fair.
All right, Tommy, that's a wrap here on Low Budget TV, but plenty of coverage to come from the Antelope Valley Fairgrounds of 2016.
Figure eight racing is in the books.